world premiere.
One of the most well-known theorists of behaviorism is Skinner, who is also thought of as the grandfather of behaviorism. Most of the credit is given to Skinner because he was responsible for the majority of the experimental research that helped define behavioral learning theory. Learners are reactive to conditions in the environment. Responses that are followed by reinforcement are more likely to recur in the future. There is also emphasis on mastering early steps before progressing to more complex levels of performance. In a math game called Count Money, learners must first identify coins. They are asked to identify certain coins by clicking on them. The second step from identifying coins is to count coins. In this stage, they learn the value of each coin. After learning how to identify coins, count coins, the final step is to count money. To be successful in this stage, learners must have mastery of the previous steps. When learners have the right answer, they are rewarded with a positive verbal response.
The object of Tower of Hanoi is to get these blocks into the third tower, moving only one block at a time and not having a bigger tower, a bigger block go over a smaller block. As you can see, how many moves I make are recorded right here, and the minimum number of moves it should take to solve the puzzle is listed right here. Once I have solved the game, I am giving a congratulations message saying I did it in 7 moves.
Second Life is a free online virtual world imagined and created by its residents. From the moment you enter Second Life, you'll discover a fast-growing digital world filled with people, entertainment, experiences, and opportunities. Second Life reflects the constructivist's learning approach based on the following elements. In constructivism, both learner and environmental factors are critical, as it is the specific interaction between these two variables that create knowledge. Second Life is consistent with the constructivist's approach to learning because users cannot be passive in a game, simulation, or virtual environment. In the gaming community of Second Life, for instance, players interact socially to discuss strategies, share experiences, and provide encouragement via websites, discussion boards, blogs, and wikis. Computer technology is a tool that aids learners in creating meaning and understanding of information. In Second Life, users explore and manipulate, communicate with other users, and build skills and knowledge in relation to their interests. Evident in the Second Life environment are two principles of constructivism. First, learner control, and second, varied presentation of information. From customizing avatars and maneuvering movements, walking or flying for example, to running businesses and buying land, users have unlimited freedom. It also presents different subject matter perspectives through several communities in the field of engineering, advertising, education, art, business, entertainment, and so much more. Users of Second Life can design, build, sell, and revise virtual objects using the built-in 3D software. This ability supports the constructivist teaching structure in which students construct, monitor, evaluate, and update meaning. In constructivism, teachers provide contexts that are authentic and relevant to learners. In Second Life, business students can run a real business or sell products and services to real people through its internal economy. It also offers authentic radio and programming experience to students in the broadcasting field. The ultimate measure of learning and constructivism is based on how effective the learner's knowledge structure is in facilitating thinking and performing using the given tools. This demonstration shows that a student solved a design and building problem by applying course content from her urban planning class to the Second Life environment. After creating a park in a donated land, she described what she did and explained the reasoning behind her decisions. The instructor and other students walked through her park, evaluated it, gave feedback, and offered suggestions for improvement. Constructivism engages learners in the actual use of tools through real-world situations and not just by following a list of rules. A good example in Second Life is the patient exam roleplay. To illustrate effective strategies for dealing with patients, students take part of the doctor, nurse, patient, or patient spouse and are able to see patient encounters from different viewpoints. After the role play, students would discuss and reflect on their experience and its application to future patient encounters.